Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, we're going to create a zero-based calendar in Outlook 365. So let's see. I do have an article here on the benefits of a zero-based calendar. I'll have a link to this in the description. Otherwise, let's move right into our calendar. So I've already got my calendar open in Outlook 365, and even though today is March 16th, I'm going to build this pretending that we're starting off here on March 29th, beginning of the spring term, and we'll have this run through the spring. I'm going to have several classes doing this as part of an initial attendance activity. Now, our zero-based calendar is what it sounds like. Zero-based calendar, a zero-based budget means you are allocating every dollar of income to some expenditure, some purpose, even if it's saving. Well, with a zero-based calendar, we're going to be allocating every minute of every day of every week to some purpose. Now, that sounds like it could be pretty tough, but remember, some of the purposes of time is sleep and rest and relaxing with family and things like that. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to start off really, really simple. For my web dev students that are doing this, we definitely have a class meeting on Mondays, and I'm looking over at my calendar off to the side, and I want to say it's like Monday at 10:15. So I'm going to jump right over to 10 o'clock on Monday the 29th. I'm going to click right in there, and I'm going to go ahead and create. Now I'll just put in the course number, CAS 195, class meeting. Okay, so that makes sense. However, I want to go into more options because there's a few other details I want to put in here. So let's see, that's Monday, and let's see, I'm going to have it go until, yeah, let's go to 12. Now it is going to repeat, so we're going to be doing this every week, every Monday. That looks good. And I want to stop it at some point, of course. Actually, I want it to go on forever, but you're going to want to stop it for sure. So let's see, we want to stop this. I think the end of the term is probably right around June 11th. That'll be finals week, so yeah, let's stop it there. June 11th. That's going to tack on an extra day, but that's okay. All right, feeling pretty good about that. So we have our first calendar event. It's going to repeat every Monday until some stopping point. I'm going to click save. Do I want a reminder? Yeah, I think I do want a reminder for this one. And 15-minute reminder sounds good for me. And I also want to color code some things. Now you get to decide what colors you want. However, let's try to put all academic related stuff into one color. All rest and relaxation and gaming into another color. Maybe all paid work, you know, your actual day job kind of stuff in a third color. We don't want to go too crazy. We don't have like a billion different colors, but maybe five distinctly different colors for the different kinds of things you're doing. Maybe exercise, fitness, health related stuff should be a color. Okay, but I'm feeling pretty good about this. I'm going to go ahead and click save right up here in the top left corner. And that's plugged in there. There's my class meeting. Great. Looks good. Looks good. Looks good. Okay, now I'm going to put another event that's going to take up a lot of time. Doesn't really matter where I click because I'm going to be customizing it. And let's see. And this is going to be sleep/rest. All right. Now I'm going to put in for the time here. I don't want it to start on 3/29, which is pretending is the start of my calendar. I'm going to go to the day before, that Sunday the 28th. And I'm going to jump right over to the end time. Actually, no, I can do it right here. Nope, got it back on the end time. I'm gonna choose custom. That'll give us a multi-day span. So let's see, I'm gonna go to bed on Sunday the 28th, and let me just scroll all the way down here, and I'm gonna pick something like 9:45 p.m. Great. I'm gonna get up the next day, Monday, March 28th, and that's gonna be something like, let's go all the way back up. I need to be in the a.m. Oh, I need to be on the 29th. March 29th, there we go. And now I can choose an early time. I'm gonna pick something kind of early just because I get up with my wife, take her to work, so I'll put down 6 a.m. Okay, that feels pretty good. Now I'm gonna go to more options, and I'm gonna set a repeat of every day for this, so all days of the week, and I will stop this again around June 11th, the end of our spring term. I'm going to click save there. I want it to be a different color. I don't want to use the standard red because that's going to be my academic related stuff. Let me head up over to category. And you can actually create named categories, which I've done already. but I'm going to pretend I don't have that. See, I've got one there for rest or buffer, and I'll just pick all categories, and then we just have different colors on here. So I think what I am going to do is, even though I've already got it used up here, I'll go ahead and choose my gray for rest buffer. That looks good. Click save, and there we go. So that's going to populate all that chunk of my calendar there, from the evening down there all the way up to the morning. That looks pretty good. Now, what if you're one of those people that occasionally you sleep in? So maybe on Saturdays and Sundays you sleep in? Cool. You could either make a separate one. You could have repeated this sleep rest for Monday through Friday and then set a different one for Saturday and Sunday. Or if you want, just make a separate event just for those days that you sleep in. Maybe it's not Saturday or Sunday, and you know, you put something down for an extra 2 hours or whatever it happens to be. I'm going to pause my recorder, and I'm going to populate the rest of my calendar. Okay, I've got my zero-based calendar filled in, so I just took a few minutes and put in some activities here. Now, when you create a calendar like this, it's not like you do it and it's done forever. This is going to be an ongoing process, and ultimately, what you need to do is, after you create your zero-based calendar, you need to start really keeping track of your time and are you sticking to your calendar. And you're not to flog yourself if you miss a particular event, but I do want you to ask yourself, am I missing this event regularly because of time conflicts or because of something that I am doing or not doing? I'll give you a quick example. I'm making this video on a Tuesday at about 2:45 p.m. And according to my calendar, I should be exercising and at the gym, or I should have been there. I should be wrapping that up and getting over to study activity development, which is kind of what I'm doing right now. So I haven't gone to the gym yet, so I'm a little bit out of whack here. But as soon as I wrap up this video, I am going to be heading to the gym before I pick up my wife from work. And then we have dinner and do that kind of stuff. So you want to look to see if there are areas in your calendar where you're regularly missing your target. Journal that, acknowledge it, and then adapt your calendar accordingly. Great feature of the zero-based calendar is that it forces you to kind of confront how you spend time doing different things. And maybe we're not all working, you know, at full speed 24 hours a day, but are you spending more time watching TV than you would prefer to? Are you spending more time gaming than you would prefer to? Are you not spending enough time with your family that you would like to? Are you not spending enough time on your studies as you would like to? Let the calendar help guide how you spend your time. And if it feels like it's too structuring, well, why is that? Is it because you jump back and forth between different activities? Maybe your blocks need to be a little bit shorter, but changing a little bit more. So whereas I have, let's say, maybe a 2-hour session for study activity development, maybe that should be 45 minutes. And then you take a quick exercise break and then another 45 minutes. So you are in control of how you spend the time in your week, for the most part, paid jobs aside. And you have the control to spend time doing the things that are important to you and important to your family's health. So definitely make your zero-based calendar. I'm going to expect my students to do it. The most common issue I get with students making this calendar is leaving big gaps of unallocated time. And they do that mostly because they don't know what they do. So think about it, give it some thought, and then put down what you do spend your time doing, but even motivate yourself by what do you want to spend your time doing. Start from that point, and then you can evaluate and refine in the days after you make your calendar. So, thanks for hanging out with me.